Platzer. I play for the London Knights in the Ontario Hockey League. And I play for the Waterloo Siskins. You can be the greatest. You can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world. You can beat the war. You can talk the guy go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up. You can beat the clock. You can move a mountain. You can break rocks. You can be a master. Don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can win. Standing in the Hall of Fame.
And now, what are you most looking forward to about the season in London?
Just continuing my hockey career and getting better every day, learning more and more, and trying to reach my goal of playing in the NHL.
And what are some things that you can take away from playing in Waterloo? What are the biggest things you learned here?
I learned a lot of little tips and tricks, like in the corner and stuff, with guys that are a lot bigger and stronger than you. Definitely paid off, I think, and I played a couple games up in London last year, and just using those puck protection tricks here and there, and it was pretty good. It was fun. I got a lot of opportunity here in Waterloo. It gave me a lot of confidence to continue my career next year in London.
For players that are looking to come into this league, the GOJHL, what is something that you would tell them about coming to Waterloo, or why would you encourage them to come to this team?
It's a great organization. Obviously, it has a lot of history, winning a lot of Sutherland Cups, and great coaching staff, obviously, great group of guys, and there's potential for a lot of wins here and more to come in the future like there was in the past, so it's just a great organization overall.
And who are you going to miss the most from the team from last year?
I'd have to say Aris and Voight. They're good to have in the room, really light in the mood before games, and yeah, they're something else, their characters. But Adam Campanola, pretty much everybody, I'd say. It was just a great group of guys I'll never forget this year. And I'm glad I played a year junior B before I went to the OHL.
What's your favorite memory from playing with this team?
Doing the Christmas carols at Christmas is probably the funniest. On the ice, it would be scoring the overtime goal against Kitchener-Dutchman with 2 seconds left. That was something I've never experienced before, and it was pretty cool to go through.
And looking ahead to training camp, what can you expect? You were there last year as well, right?
Yeah. Obviously, it's going to be a hard, fast-paced, competitive camp. Everyone's going to be looking to make the team. We should have a good young group of guys this year again and make a push for an MCOP.
And I guess one more thing that you want to say to all the new players coming into the Siskins this year and the team for the 2012-2013 season?
Just keep working hard, you know. It's teams that win hockey games, not individuals. Here in Waterloo, we didn't have the most skilled individuals, but as a team, we're real powerful, and we can make some noise here and there. So just stick together and work your hardest.
And I guess going back to when you started playing hockey, when did you know that you wanted to do this, you know, professionally and work your way up to the OHL?
Pretty much right away. Obviously, I didn't know much about the OHL, but the NHL and guys like Eric Lindros and stuff like that, they're definitely idols for me, and it was something to keep me motivated when I was a young kid, not knowing too much about the outside world.
And favorite game day pregame meal?
Chicken and pasta. That's the favorite.
And that'll continue on into London?
Yeah, oh, for sure.
And so you just met with your billets as well earlier this week, so that makes it really real that you're going there, but what are some other things that you're looking forward to in London, and is it going to be weird for you moving away?
Yeah, actually going and visiting my billets is a great experience. Obviously, they're great people, great house. It's pretty surreal going there and coming back home and just thinking, like, I'm leaving here in 2 weeks kind of thing, and I gotta say goodbye to all my good friends and leave them all behind and start a new life. So it's something that hit me pretty hard, but it's something you gotta do if you wanna keep getting better and moving on your hockey career, and it's all about maturity, so I think I'm ready for it, and it'll be a great time.
Anything else you wanna say?
Yeah.